So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about inverse functions. We are going to define the inverse function. So let us take f from set A to B. Be any function which is a bijective function. Be a bijective function. So remember, if you want to find inverse of some function, that function has to be a bijective function. Now, what is a bijective function? Bijective function means a function which is 1, 1 and onto both. It should be 1, 1 and onto. So if you are given a function and if you are asked to find the inverse of that function, the first question that should come in your mind is that, is this function first of all a bijective function? Is it 1, 1 and onto? Only then I will find the inverse of that function. Okay, so f is a bijective function in my mind. Now all of us know that if I take this function I, which is from set A to set A itself, and I'm going to define this function as I of x is equal to x, means what is this function going to do? It is going to map every point x to itself. It is going to map the point A to it A itself. It is going to map B to B itself. So all points will be mapped to themselves. This function is called as the identity function. Be the identity function. Then the inverse function is G. G is from B to A. F is from which set to which set? F is from A to B. And I'm going to define B from what? I'm going to define the inverse function G from what? G, I'm going to define from B to A. Such that the composition of G composite F, this composition G composite F should be the identity function. G composite F should be the identity function. Not only that, F composite G should also come to be the identity function. Now this identity function is different from this identity function. So let me denote IA as identity function on A, and this is IA, and this identity function I'm going to denote by IB. Now what is IB? Simply, IB is again the same function which is from B to B. And what is the job of that function IA and IB? It maps every x to itself. This is the definition of the inverse function. Who is the inverse function here? G is called the inverse function of F. Okay, let me give you one simple diagram below so that the above definition will be clear to you. So I will draw set A from A to B, and again from B to A, I will draw to a function. From A to B, you have the function F. From B to A, we have defined the inverse function, which is called a G. So if I take a point X here, that point will map to F of X. And this F of X point under the function G will map to the point g of f of x. So g of f of x is from x to g of f of x. This function will be denoted by what? This function will be denoted by, will it be f composite g? No, it is going to be g composite f. This g composite f function is from which set to which set? This g composite f function is from set A to set A. And this composite function, g composite f of x, should be equal to how much? I of x. But what is I of x? I of x is defined to be x, means g composite f of x must be equal to how much? Must be equal to x. If this composition comes up to be x, then I will say that g is the inverse of f. If the composition, after simplification, okay, g composite f, I have to simplify. If the composition g composite f turns to be x, then g is called inverse of f, inverse function of f, right? So now let us take one simple example to understand this inverse functions. So question, I will first teach you in this part, I will first teach you how to find the inverse function, and then we will check whether the inverse function found is correct or not. Okay, so the question is, let f be from R to R be defined by f of x is equal to 2x plus 3. Find the inverse function of f. Find the inverse function of f. Solution. Now, this function, if I want to find the inverse of this function, we all know that this function must be which type of a function? It must be a bijective function. Otherwise, I won't be able to find the inverse of this function. So f of x equal to 2x plus 3 is a 1-1 function, is a onto function. This has been already discussed in the previous classes. So I will not discuss now here. Okay. F is bijective. Okay, can be checked. So once the function is bijective, now I can find the inverse function, right? Now what I will do is I will take this f of x and I will call it y. So let, to find the inverse function, this is the method we will always follow. Okay, let y be equal to 2x plus 3. If you look at this equation, you will understand that y is expressed in terms of x. Y is expressing because y is nothing but depending on x. If x changes, the value of y will also change. If x goes on changing on the right hand side, the entire right hand side expression will start changing, and accordingly, the value of y will also start changing. For example, if I put x equal to 1, the value of y will be 5. If I put x equal to 2, then the value of y will be 2 into 2 plus 3, which is 7. Then y will become 7. So if x changes, y changes. It means that y is here depending on what? Y is here depending on x. Now what we will do is we will reverse the job. We will solve this equation, or we will simplify this equation in such a way so that x will start depending on y. Okay, now the actual situation is that y depends on x, but now we will change the jobs of x and y so that x will start depending on y. This means that I have to leave x alone. So I will get y minus 3 is equal to 2x. And therefore, the value of x in terms of y will be x is equal to y minus 3 upon 2. So now you see that x is expressed in terms of the equation. The meaning of the equation has not changed, correct? Only x is expressed in terms of y, right? That is the thing now. Now what I will do is this right hand side, I will take y minus 3 upon 2, and in that right hand side I will change the variable. Instead of taking the variable y, I will just replace the variable y by what? I will replace the variable y by x again. So what will I get? Replace y by x. So what will that become? Only I'm writing the right hand side. Okay, the right hand side will become what? X minus 3 upon 2. Okay, this is what I've got, and this person will be my g of x. This person will be called as the inverse of the above function. Okay, who was the original function? The original function was f of x equal to 2x plus 3, and this gx which I've got, x minus 3 upon 2, will be called as the inverse of the given function. So let me write f and g again. So what is f? F of x was 2x plus 3. And what is g of x? G of x is equal to x minus 3 upon 2. Now, is this inverse correct? Now, what is the definition of inverse? The definition of inverse says that if g is inverse of f, then g composite f of x, after simplification, what should it become? It should just become x. If it just becomes x, then my inverse is correct. So let us just check, is g composite f of x equal to x? So inverse is found out. Okay, now I'm just checking whether the inverse is correct or not. Is g composite f of x equal to x? So let me start from the left hand side. G composite f of x is equal to g of f of x, which is equal to g of, what is f of x? F of x is 2x plus 3. F of x is how much? F of x is 2x plus 3. Now what is g of 2x plus 3? What is g? Look at g carefully. G of something is equal to what? Something minus 3 divided by 2. Because g of x is x minus 3 divided by 2. So what will be g of 2x plus 3 according to this logic? Now the place of dot is played by what? 2x plus 3. So it will be that 2x plus 3 will be written as it is. Then I'm going to subtract 3 from it, right? It is something minus 3, and everything will be divided by what? Everything will be divided by 2. Okay, so it is 2x plus 3 minus 3 divided by 2. So it is clear that this 3 and 3 cancels, and you will get what? 2x upon 2, and this 2x upon 2 reduces to how much? It reduces to x. So now you understand that g composite f of x is simplified to how much? Is simplified to just x. Not only this, not only g composite f is identity, but f composite g also must come to be identity, right? So what is f composite g of x? Let us calculate that and see. Does it comes up to be the identity function x? So f composite g of x is f of g of x, which is equal to f of, what is g of x? G of x is x minus 3 upon 2, which is f my x minus 3 upon 2. What is f of something? What is f of x actually? F of x was 2x plus 3, right? So f of x was 2x plus 3 means f of something is equal to 2 into something. 2 into something plus 3. Correct. So what is f of x minus 3 upon 2? So who is going to play the role of this big dot over here? F of x minus 3 upon 2 will be equal to 2 into that something, which is x minus 3 upon 2 plus. And then I'm going to add a 3. So does this simplifies to x again? This 2 and 2 cancels, and I will get that it is x minus 3 plus 3. And again, this 3 and 3 cancel, and I will get what? I will get x back. So this means that this f composite g of x is also coming to be x, which is the I of x, which is called as what? Which is called as I of x. So we have that f composite g of x is nothing but equal to I of x. And this means if I just don't write x on both the sides, what will I write it to be? I will say that this means that f composite g is nothing but I. And we have also derived that g composite f of x was also I of x, which was x. And therefore g composite f is also equal to I. So this we have verified that both the compositions are coming to be equal to identity. Therefore, now it is confirmed that g function that we have got, which was x minus 3 upon 2 or something like that, okay, that is actually the inverse of the function fx equal to 2x plus 3. Okay.